Divide the fractions, 3/4 divided by 2/5. I'm going to show you the visual method and also the abstract method. So the first thing we need to do for the visual method to work is we need a common denominator. The reason why is because if you just draw 3/4, okay, so let's say there's 1, 2, 3/4. How do you fit 2/5 into here? Well, I don't know, it's really confusing. So what I do is I do a common denominator. Common denominator here is 20, so I'm going to multiply this first fraction by 5. So it's going to be 5 over 5 multiplied here and here. 5 times 3 is 15, divided by 5 times 4, which is 20. And then over here, to make this a denominator of 20, it's 5 times 4, so each of these gets multiplied by 4. So 2 times 4 is 8, 5 times 4 is 20. See, now we have a common denominator, and this is an equivalent division question, just written a little differently. Okay, so now let's make that visual model. Okay, so maybe something like that. Okay, now this whole big rectangle is supposed to represent a unit of 1. So each little box here is 1/20 because I divided it up into 20 pieces. Now 15/20, let's see, probably the easiest way is to do these three rows here. Because this is 15 out of the 20 boxes. Okay, so the question is, how many times does 2/5 or 8/20 now with a common denominator go into 15/20? So all I need to do is count these 15 boxes by 8 and see what we get. So here's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so it doesn't go in evenly into the 15, but it goes in once, and then plus there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 left over out of the 8 you're trying to get, because you're trying to get groups of 8 here, right? Okay, so you have 7 out of 8 left over. Well, guess what? That is the answer for your division, 1 7/8. Now let me show you the abstract way. 3/4 divided by 2/5. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the reciprocal, or flip this second fraction, and then multiply straight across. So 3/4 then times 5/2. It's the exact same thing. So multiply straight across. 5 times 3 is 15, and then divided by 4 times 2, which is 8, 15/8. Well, if you turn that into a mixed number, you get 1 7/8. So this is the exact same solution. So I'm hoping you start to see the connection between this visual model here and the abstract method here. So they both work equally well. The difference is this abstract model works much more efficiently, especially when you have complex fractions. Sometimes it's really hard to illustrate with a visual model if you have weird fractions. So that's why the abstract method is taught as well.